What is up, guys? Today is December 13th, 2019, aka Friday the 13th. And I'm coming to you with some reddish purple hair. I was trying out something new. I don't know what you guys think about it, but I don't care. This year I've been trying a lot of colors. I did really light blonde earlier this year. And I'm hoping to eventually get towards wearing blue because I want to experiment with stuff. But today I bring you my reaction slash review of Harry Styles, the Harry Styles new album that just dropped today. Ironically, he chose Friday the 13th to drop it. I don't know why, but I'm gonna give you my little feelings on almost each and every song. I don't know if y'all peeped this though, but like, and Watermelon Sugar, like, what the Megan Thee Stallion is that song about? Like, because everything has like this kind of 50s vibes, you won't really like catch it, but I always really, really listen to like music, and that Watermelon Sugar, it sounds nice and sweet, like the fruit itself, but that's a nasty song right there. Like, I'm gonna show y'all where I'm getting that from. Treat people with kindness. That's one of his songs. I wasn't making a quote, but I don't know, that might sound a little gospel to me. I don't know if that's what he was going for, but I'll let y'all form your own opinion and play it right now. Like, I really appreciate in Canyon Moon how he really like opened up. I feel like that one was a really personal song. So I don't really know, like, I guess he's just trying to like kind of let us know a little bit more about himself in this album. I really wish I listened to the first one, like, so that I could see the difference. But I believe when that first one came out, he was younger. So it's probably sound just like One Direction music, which that's perfectly fine. I love their music. But this one, he's giving us some more grown, mature side. But what is really up with Sunflower? What is that really about? Because I feel like that's another little Megan Thee Stallion he's trying to get in that one. Like, that one sound like, I'm trying to see Harry Styles, what is a Sunflower? Please tell us. All right, and there's another one that's called She. I really don't know where he got the inspiration for that song, because what I'm hearing in that song is some kind of like affair going on, or not necessarily that the two people are not single, but he said like they're in the office and she's always the first one that he sees. And I'm just like, he dropped his kids off at school. So I'm just like, or maybe he is with someone, I don't know. I don't even see how he can relate to that kind of song. I don't know where he got the inspiration for that. You know what? I'm gonna just let y'all hear it and y'all form your own opinion. Give me one second. It's real dark in the beginning.
Like a investor.
Very creative. I don't know where he got the inspiration for the song, honey. Okay, that part was from To Be So Lonely. Can somebody tell me what instrument that was? Because I don't know, that just sounded strange to me. I don't know, like, yikes. Fallen, I have such a soft spot for that song. He said, I'm aware I write too many songs about you. About, like, that thing just gets me in my feelings. Like, Fallen's another good one. I like that one too. Now, his song Cherry, as soon as it started, I was like, this sounds like a mixture of Hater, Delilah, and We Don't Talk Anymore. I was getting that kind of vibe, but you would look at that song and be like, okay, Cherry, maybe it's gonna be like Watermelon Sugar High, but nah, that was a very like emotional song. Like, this man is grown. I need to show y'all exactly, like, I don't know. Y'all can tell me if y'all was feeling the same way about that song, but I'm gonna just play the part that made me feel that way, and y'all tell me in the comments y'all reaction. I like the new ukulele in there. Don't you call him baby. Don't you call him baby. We're not talking lately. Don't you call him what you used to call me. That was deep. I confess. Ooh, what are we confessing here? I can tell that you are at your own best. Selfish, so I'm hating it. Do it. We're not talking lately. Nope, nope. Oh my God. And the song Golden, it really had me. He said this one verse. He's like, I know you're so scared because I'm so open. And I'm just like, I don't even know what that means, but that really got me. Okay, so my in all opinion of this album is that I feel like he's trying to show us that he's more older now. I did not hear his first album, so I can't even say I could compare the first album to this one now, because he might have tried to give the same feeling in that other one, but I feel like he's trying to let us know that he grown. He a grown man out here. And also, from beginning all the way to end, he did a really good job setting the mood in his album, because it's all hype and it keeps on being hype from the beginning. And then once you get to the very last song, which is called Fine Line, it's very sad and emotional. And I guess he was in his feelings. So my favorite song from this album is Sunflower. Sunflower is my shit. I love that song. I love the way it sounds. By the way, I'm a music head. I listen to all types of music. So I don't know if it would be surprising to some of you that I would actually listen to Harry Styles' album, but I listen to everything. So you're gonna see me giving my review / reaction to many different types of music. So you're gonna get that from me. And then the song that I was kind of like, eh, with, although let me stop you there. Harry Styles fans, do not attack me. All of his songs were good, but I'm just giving you my most favorite and my least favorite. So my least favorite, I would say, is Adore You, because it didn't really make me feel anything. Like, from all the other songs, like, I felt something, or like, it really had me thinking, but I don't know, Adore You just was blah. Yes, Julia Rohrbach, also congratulations to her for winning the Helium Comedy Club tickets from my first video. You guys want to know how to get the free iTunes gift cards. So to do that, you have to be the person, like in my last video, to get the most people to follow me, including yourself. The way that I'm going to tally it, and if you want to do the leisure of tallying it yourself, is each person who follows has to comment under this video the contestant's name, the word win in caps, and I'm going to count it up, and I'm going to give y'all a week again to see who's the winner. Next video, tomorrow, I'm going to be going to 92Q Winterfest here in Baltimore, Maryland at the Royal Farms Arena to see my very first rap concert. I've been to a lot of concerts this year. Yes, a couple of them had rappers that were in the lineup, but very, very few. Like, only two shows had rappers in the lineup, but this is my first full-blown hip-hop rap concert. Like, it's gonna be real crazy in there, and I'm really excited. So I will get that video to you as quickly as I can with, of course, another giveaway, like I do every single video. And Tina Aina will keep up with you next time. Bye, guys!